In dental hygiene, there are three of us that are exploring the use of interactive learning guides. Professor Pope is using it for head and neck anatomy. Professor Stabby is using it for therapeutics and local anesthesia. And I'm using it for preclinic. And the reason I'm using it for preclinic is I have a lot of students that have absolutely no dental experience coming into my class. They need to learn a lot of information in a short amount of time, and then they need to apply it. And sometimes they need to apply it in 2 or 3 days. So I have decided to use the interactive learning guide for my students so that I will lecture on the information for them. We also demonstrate it in clinic, and then they go through competency evaluations. And this information on my Angel course will provide them a supplementary way of presenting the information in a different way so that they can use it to review what I've told them in class and what they've seen in clinic. And the advantage of it is that we're actually using pictures from the clinic.
Hi, I'm Kim Grubbs. I teach in the Emergency Medical Sciences programs here at Johnson County Community College, and I've been asked to talk a little bit about our use of Camtasia and Camtasia Relay, i.e. Lecture capture as well as studio capture in the emergency medical science courses. So we've been doing this for several years now, and we have found live capture to be a very effective tool for students who may be absent on a given day of class, and giving them the opportunity to gain the same material that students who were present in the face-to-face classroom had, as well as a very effective tool, review tool, for students who were present who want to go back and review the material. Not only exam scores between our various sectional offerings, as well as on national certification exams, reflect that it is a very effective and perhaps even a superior learning environment.
WordPress works fantastically for communicating with students because you can post content that you want to share with your students. It really gives you the ability to extend your classroom beyond the four walls of the physical space. So instead of just sending a hyperlink to a student and saying, you should check this out for your research paper, you can actually post whatever that content is. If it's a video, audio clip, a link, some text, PDF, what have you. You can post that to your WordPress blog, your professor blog, whatever you want to call it. And with that, then not just that one student, but the entire class can see it. And you can have them focus on going to that one site, your site, and checking that content on a regular basis. WordPress integrates very well with other social media tools. You can build Facebook and Twitter into your WordPress blog. You can have your WordPress blog communicate with your Facebook and Twitter accounts. So from that perspective, knowing WordPress has ramifications beyond the college. Bringing it back within the walls of the college, though, you can apply that same concept to your classroom. From a training perspective, WordPress is a dream, actually. It's quite easy. If you can type into a web form, you can blog and post and publish content to the web with WordPress.
I'm Diana Ryan, and I teach the floral design classes here at Johnson County Community College. And a lot of my coursework involves repetitive, over and over practice on the skills that they learn each week. And a lot of the students would find themselves getting behind because every week we advance and go on to another topic. So I recognized this, and I went to the Ed Tech Center and kind of presented this problem to them. How can I make this classroom experience available to them at their leisure so that they can practice on their own outside the classroom? So Bob and Zach and I worked on videos last semester so that the students can view these. And like I say, practice on their own anytime they want. So starting next semester, they will be available through YouTube, a link to YouTube that I'm going to give them. And eventually I'd like to have it available on Angel as a course shell that they can also access. And the goal here, like I say, they can practice this over and over at their own time, at home, or here at the college, so that they develop that skill and get it to a proficiency that they need to be successful in the industry.